All right, so you want to do some production. You want to be a producer. You want to somehow do a remix on the fly. Let's go back to the 80s, when dance music started to just tweak its way into the top 40, proper dance music. You had a producer and you had a DJ. And it was very rare to see the producer be a DJ or the DJ be a producer, because they were different people. The producer was a producer because he or she had a studio and had all the kit. Imagine going back and having a look at one of the original computers. It would fill this entire room and it wouldn't be as powerful as an iPhone, the original iPhone. Seriously. So it was the same with a producer. You had to have big reel-to-reels, you had to have the studio, you had to have just like loads of kit all over the place, whereas the DJ, a couple of turntables and a mixer. Now, the DJ then could get a couple of records, the same record, and go from one side to the other, but there was a lot of work involved. Now, with the technology we have keyboards, we have samplers, we have effects units. The DJ now is pretty much, or can be, the producer. And the producer is also a DJ now, or a lot of them are. And again, a small tip here. If you want to start earning a great deal of money in your DJing life, then start music production. Because that's one way how you can get gigs in big nightclubs. Because management, they want someone who has their own tracks. In other words, you walk in with a thumb drive, you go, see these tunes, these are mine, no one else has got them. Management are going to love that shit because no one else has heard it. So how can you become a producer while you're DJing? Well, it's very simple. Just do remixes of tracks. Now, I am very much against master and slave and sync and whatnot, but sometimes it's worth doing. Why? Well, all right. I know. You said why. It's because when you have master and sync engaged, you're guaranteed that the two tracks or track you're playing is going to be in time, which means more of your thought process and energy can be involved in your effects instead of trying to beat match something. Okay. Now, the track I'm using is by Flashung. Flashung. Dyslexic. Sometimes you just look at the word, you go, all words jumble around, it's terrible. It's a track entitled Loving You. So what I've got the XDJ RX2. I've got a bunch of loops on the right. I've got one on the left. Now I'm using Rekordbox and I've got Quantize engaged. Quantize is engaged simply because when I press the in and I press the out, Quantize will go, hold on a minute, you were a millisecond too soon on the in and you were a millisecond too late on the out. So we're going to just make sure it's in perfect time for you. That's why Quantize is great. Snaps it in time for you. So here, got a bunch of loops. And one over this side. Okay, so let's just get out of that loop. So again, once I have formed the loop, I have set that in one of the hot cues. Now you should see a load of amber squares there on the hot cues. That's telling me that all of those now are loops. Whereas if I don't do a loop, I just press that there, it's green, and that's a hot cue. I just put that anywhere. Press shift, press it again, it's now deleted. Okay. Okay, so we're on a loop here that I made earlier. Let's just do another loop now on the left-hand side. Let's maybe go to the drop. Go back a bit. Nope, too far. Not there. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. I'm just going to do a bit longer loop. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. There you go. Put that there. Okay, so we want to make a remix. Now, again, the demonstration is one thing, but it's about you listening and working it out for yourself. Now, I have made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 loops on the right hand side, and I've made those in order based on how the track is flowing. Number 1 is the beginning of the track, 2 is further on from 1, 3 and so on, 4 to the 7th loop, which is sort of towards the end of the track. It's actually not towards the end, it's about the middle. This is the radio version, and I've got an extended on this side. So what I'm going to do is, and again, without headphones, because I want to sort of talk while I'm doing this, is, you know, I'm going to play a loop on this side and maybe add some effects, and then start a loop on that side, and then slowly mix that in, and then come to another loop on this side. So potentially what I'm doing is I will be remixing the track. Now, if you think about it, the first loop on the top left hand hot cue button or loop button is the beginning. The next one is further on, third and so on that I did say earlier. But I don't have to play that one first, then that one second and that one third, because it was first, second or third. I could play the third one first, or the seventh one second, or the fourth one third. Do you get it? You see, this is remixing on the fly, so... bring the volume down. Roll. Say no more. 2, 3, 4. side. Oh my god. No, it looks difficult, but it's not. It is so simple. It's so simple. But let's take this to another level. Let's just take this to new heights. I'm using the same track, all right? Radio extended. Just think what it would be like if you used different tracks. If you used a track and an a cappella. If you used two a cappellas. If you had four decks and used the same track on two, a different track on the other, and an a cappella on the other. The mind boggles. And it's up to you to do a bit of boggling. Practice and boggling. Practice and enjoy.